watching this video for the first time, please don't forget to subscribe our channel and do not forget to press the bell icon so that you will get notification of any future videos which will be uploaded in our channel. So today what we are going to take into consideration is knowing something about ME engines, MOP. So ME engines is basically an electronic engine, MAN, BMW, that is the ME engines. So ME engines are more simpler and more easier than our MC engines. So everything is controlled by MOP, we call it as the main operation panel. So we can control the entire engine operation with the MOP. So I want to show you some information about what are all the things that we can check using our MOP panel. So in all our ME engines, in control room we'll be having a two panel, which is MOP A and MOP B. Here we got our MOP, which is connected to this COCOS. This COCOS is nothing but it will show you the information about your cylinder condition. So you can watch everything. You can see here, you can see the exhaust valve opening stroke, exhaust valve closing stroke, exhaust valve close position. Everything you can monitor from this COCOS. And if you want to see the parameters, like if you want to see the PMAX, PCOM, you can see over here. And this MOP is connected to this COCOS. And the value of this PMAX, PCOM and everything is connected to our main engine. So from main engine, we take the signal, and the signal is given by the main engine parameter, which we have a booster for each and every unit. For each and every unit, we have a CCU, and from that unit you will get signal, you will get the condition of your main engine performance, and it is transferred to this COCOS. And from here you can see from your MOP POs. So now I want to show what are all the things that we can do with our MOP. So the reason they are given two MOP is basically if one MOP got some problem, we can use the other one. And here this MOP, if MOP B is getting any problem, then you don't see any information in your COCOS, because your MOP B is directly connected to your main engine. So from there information comes here, and from here information is transferred to your COCOS. So what are all the things that you can see in your MOP? So first you can see this is your, if you go here, you can see the status. You can see the status, and you can see the hydraulic oil pressure, how many blowers running, you can see the crankshaft position, you can see whether the turning gear is engaged or disengaged, you can see the control air pressure, and you can see the status of your main engine. So now the main engine is running, and you can see the starting air pressure, and you can see the control air pressure. And once you see the status of this, if you find everything is green, that means your unit is perfectly alright. If you find anything in red color, that means that particular information shows that there is some problem in your any of the system. Like if turning gear disengage is shown in red color, that means the turning gear is having some problem. Either it is not disengaged properly, or your control air pressure is showing red color, that means your control air pressure is low. And same with the other thing, if there is any abnormality, it will show in green red color. If everything is normal, it will show in green color. And if it is any abnormal, it will be showing in red color. So next will be your process information. Okay, so I'll go for process information. Process information, you can see there is three mode.
One is running mode, one is speed control, and is LDCL. So we go for the running mode first. So in running mode, you can see in which mode your engine is running. Now it is running in economy mode. And what is the set RPM for your engine? Now the engine is set in 21 RPM and fuel index is 4%, and hydraulic oil set pressure and scavenge point, variable EGB set point, and every information you can see here. So this is your, this all units will be your set point, and this is your actual point. So here the engine RPM set is 21 and actual is 21, so it is okay. So hydraulic oil set pressure is 225 and actual is 224, it's okay. So you can see the, you can set any point in this mode. And next will be your speed control. Speed control, you can see everything. So now the engine is in bridge control. So here it is shown bridge, and again speed set and index of your fuel lever and present index and your speed RPM. So you can see everything, your everything over here. And next is your LDCL. LDCL is your load dependent cylinder liner cooling water system. So you can see here you can see it is a failure. So if it is any failure, it will show us red color. So that means this LDCL mode is failure. It indicates that any of your system in this LDCL mode is not normal. So here in our ship, we had kept the LDCL pump. So this LDCL, you can see in our ship, we had stopped the LDCL pump. So it is showing its failure. And next will be your process adjustment. If you go to the process adjustment, you can see four columns. One is auto tuning, one is cylinder load, the other is cylinder pressure, and other is index calibration. So this auto tuning is nothing but it will automatically, when you press the auto tuning, for you can do the auto tuning for Pmax, Pcom, and your deviation also. So for, if you do for Pmax, the engine will do the stabilization or power balance of your Pmax. So it will be, so now you can see it is power is imbalanced. One is up, down, up, down. When it is totally out of balance, then it will indicate in yellow color and red color. Then that means you have to do the auto tuning. If you do the auto tuning, the engine by itself will balance the power of all the units. So this we can do for all 1, 2, 3, or you can do it together all time. See, you can see now it is coming is minus 3.2, which is about abnormal power balance between the units. So if I press this and I go for you can see here Pmax and all. Now since engine is in maneuvering RPM, we cannot do the auto tuning. When it is at full ahead, we can do the auto tuning for this for this page. Next will be your cylinder load. Cylinder load, you can see you can set the cylinder load for each and every unit. Whether if you feel like some units have some problem, so you don't want to give more load on that engine, so you can reduce it by clicking here up down. You can see here you can make any changes by clicking up down everything. And once you are done with this, you have to apply or cut. So that whatever setting you do, that system unit will take into account and it will do the setting accordingly. So you can do either high load or low load, both. And next will be your cylinder pressure. So you can see the Pmax, Pcom, and exhaust valve opening time in this area. And again, you can do adjustment by doing the values. You can give new values or old values. You can increase, decrease the value, and you have to just apply, and the engine will start acting according to your command. So here in this page, you can see you can do settings for Pmax, Pcom, and your exhaust valve opening timing. And next is your index calibration. Index calibration is nothing. It is actually the fuel which you are using currently in your, for your main engine. So you have to, if you do any changes, if you are changing your fuel oil, suppose you take a new bunker, or you are changing out to HFO to LFO, VLSFO, diesel oil, whatever. So you have to just put the calorific value and density and your fuel temperature. So accordingly, the the unit will calibrate itself to do the necessary adjustment. So next will be your chief limiters. Chief limiters is nothing like you are adjusting your fuel rack. So here we had given a fuel limiter to 80. So the main engine can give fuel until 80%. So if I want to give more, I have to either add. You can see I am adding 84, 85. So once I add, I have to apply. So I press apply. Then now you can see here the unit will come as 85. Once it is applied, then yeah, you can see the new value came. So if I want to decrease the limit, again what I need to do is I have to put back to normal and again press apply. It will come back to the value that you had given. So here you can each and individual unit you can adjust the fuel rack. Suppose you got some problem with any of your unit and you don't want to give more fuel for that particular unit, all you need to do is click the individual unit. Suppose this is number 3 unit, I have to do the same way, either increase or decrease, and I have to apply so that that particular unit will be acting according to the value that you had given. That means the fuel will be limited for that particular unit. So in this area you can see the maximum speed, engine speed, maximum load percentage and compression. So all these values you can see, and you can see the exhaust valve operation also here. And if you find anything in red color, that means there is something abnormal in that particular unit. So next we will go for auxiliaries. Auxiliaries is nothing but your hydraulic system, scaven system, cylinder lubrication. So first we will go for the hydraulic system. So this is your hydraulic system. Hydraulic system is very important for your ME engines, because hydraulic system, this hydraulic pump is the one which is activating your fuel oil actuator and exhaust valve actuator and everything. So you can see here you can find 3 pumps and plus 2 pumps. So these 3 pumps you can see, and you can see 2 more pumps over here. And these 3 pumps you can see, on number 1 pump is CTRL, that is control, FOLW, that is follow, and again this is follow. So this will be the main pump and these 2 will be the follower for the other pump. So these 3 pump and these 2 pumps you can find what is the status of this particular pumps. And this is your master pumps, and this is your number 2 master pump. So all these 5 pumps are motor operated. You can see a symbol called M over here. So this is all 5 number pumps are motor operated, and this is engine operated. So presently, since the vessel is in doing maneuvering, so this is stopped. Now the motor operated pump is running. So you can see the value of the pressure which is given by the pump. You can see the 224 bar is the delivery pressure, and inlet for the oil is 2.7 bar pressure. So if you click the details, you can see, if you click detail, you can see every information. And if you again click it, you have a plain information of it. Next we go for the scavenger. If you see the scavenge mode, you can see 2, one is main, other is process value. So when you go for main, you can see whether it is in bypass mode, and you can see the exhaust, the position of your FB, the exhaust receiver, engine, everything. Here you can see your scavenge air pressure. Now you can see the pressure is 0.07, and all the 3 auxiliary blowers are running, and your turbocharger RPM you can see here. And okay, so next will be your cylinder lubrication. So cylinder lubrication, again you can adjust for each and every unit. Suppose if you overhauled a new unit and you want to increase the lubrication for that particular unit for a running period, you can just click that unit, increase, decrease, and you have to apply. Then you will get, your system will take that particular unit as setting and it will act accordingly. So in this you can see the flow per hour and nominal feed rate, and how it's controlled, is RPM control, torque control, whatever. And you can see the running in. Running in means, suppose if we do a new overhaul, and you have to switch on this running in so that it will take the program of running in features. So here you can see the feed rate factor. Now we are running in 0.1 sulfur, so you have to feed this. You, for this particular thing, one main information is you have to feed the sulfur value of your fuel which is using for the engine. So now we are using 0.1%, so we put that value, so it will act accordingly. So minimum feed rate, everything will be here, pre-loop, everything is can be controlled from this area. Next will be your maintenance. So maintenance part, you can see HCU, TACO, HPS, speed handles and everything. HCU. So this is your HCU, and you can see HCU is your hydraulic control unit. So you can individually find the value condition of your individual unit. Suppose this is this engine have 11 units. So you can see the 11 numbers. So I go for number 1. So you can see the LP valve position, how much it is taking current, your fuel valve position and LP position for exhaust valve, everything you can find over here. And the more information you can see here also. So you can see the test, this test of LP and exhaust valve, this is nothing like once you are doing your any maintenance, after that if you want to test, you can do the testing of your exhaust valve, whether it is opening or closing, that you can do the testing without starting your main engine. And you can do the same testing for your fuel valves also, and all these testing should be done only when the engine is in off condition. So you can check for each and every unit. And next will be your TACO. TACO is tachometer actually. You can see the conditions of your turning wheel, turning gear and everything. You can see all this turning gear, ahead position, everything you can, regarding your TACO information you will get here. And HPS, you can, this is your hydraulic power supply. I told you earlier also, we have 3 pumps over here, and you can see the condition of your pumps, each and every pumps. So you can see the splash plate angle, whether what angle, how much current it is taking, and you can compare with the other pumps also. So you get all the reading for your HPS over here. And this is your speed handle. Speed handle is nothing, this is your maneuvering, when is engine stopped, when is engine position basically. So you can see here, this is your command. Now ECR or LOP, everything you can monitor over here. So next we go for your maintenance. This is your system view input output test. So here in this panel you have to see everything in green tick. If you find anything in your red color, that means there is some problem in that particular unit. You can see the CCU and EACU, everything in green color, that means everything in normal operation parameters. So now it is okay. If it is any red color, then that particular unit, suppose if this EACU B is in red color, then there is some problem in your EACU B. So you have to troubleshoot on that particular panel. Then we go for invalidated input channels. If there is any error in your input channel, it will be shown here. And your network status here, this is your overall view of your network status, because here you can see the condition of your MOP, EACU, ECU, ACU, everything you can see here. Again, if you find any red mark, red color mark, that means that is the area there is some problem. So you can see here also, if you find a red color, it is shown no communication. So you have to attack on that particular area. So next will be your function test. Function test is nothing I said earlier. And troubleshooting, again here in this you can see HCU, HPS, HCU events, HPS events, cylinder lubrication, cylinder events, insulation and everything. And if you go for HCU, you can HCU is basically give your condition of your alpha and LP valves. So here if you see, you can see the LP, alpha and exhaust valve position, how much stroke it is opening, what is the maximum and minimum current it is taking, and the same you will get for your fuel valve position also, fuel pressure position and exhaust valve position. You can see for each and every unit. See, each and every unit have individual page for it, and you can compare the value and you can find the value. Next is your HPS. HPS is again your valve position, your splash plate, your hydraulic oil pressure, the proportional valve, everything, all this information you can find in this page. Next will be your HCU units. This HCU units is if you want to compare any of your value, so show sequence. So this is how you have to see. So I check for CCU number 3. You can see the opening closing of that particular unit. That is here you can see. Yellow color is LP set point, LP feedback, and this is your set point, and this is your condition of your unit, whichever we are looking. So if I go CCU4 and I want to show sequence again, now it is comparing to CCU3 and CCU4. That means you can compare the performance of any two units, or if you want to go for three units, I can go for three units. That means I can check the performance of all three units in one page. So this is how we can do the checking of your condition of your particular unit or two, three units. And next will be your HPS events. Again, same, show sequence. And next will be cylinder lubrication. This cylinder lubrication is for testing whenever you are doing any maintenance in your cylinder oil lubrication. So if you want to check whether the lubrication is working or not, you just on it and you can see whether the oil is splashing on your liner. Then is your cylinder events. Again, same, what are all the things happening in your cylinder, you can see here. And insulation, which is very important, and you can see the insulation of your all the panels over here. Noise pulse meter, you can see insulation. This is for CCU, ACU and everything. So next will be your admin. You can see your local date, time, whatever. And this is your power off. Now system option is in chief. So this is your alarm. If there is any alarm, it will show your alarm list. And this is your manual cutout list. So presently we are cut out the LDCL manually. So it is showing it's cut off. It will be your event log. What is happened in your engine? You can see everything over here. It is like alarm history. Next will be your alarm list. If there is any live alarm, it will show, it will display in this page. So I think this information gives you some knowledge about this MOP panel.
Okay, I think I given some basic information about your MOP for ME engines. So I have not given much detail, but I have given